welcome to this blues lesson. For this blues lesson, I found some great melodic lines that works that I play over or through the chords of the blues. And it's a really good idea to practice such exercises, because that's a great way to get the melodic feeling or the melodic lines into your fingers and into your heart, so you can play it in an actual playing situation. And they would work great over jazz blues in C, most jazz blues in C, and also some shuffle in C. And at first, just after talking here, I will show you the licks, and after that I will show you and comment on the chords, so you know what the chords are and why they come like they come. Okay, let's take a close look at these melodic ideas that I played through a jazzy blues in C. We're in the key of C, and the first 8 bars, it's almost exactly the same as when you play a blues shuffle. So, and we start up in the 13th fret, the 2nd string, move up to the 1st string, chromaticism, hammer on here from the 11th to the 12th fret. And then you have a C arpeggio. And then there's a small lick again. Hammer on here from the 8th to the 9th fret. Arpeggio. And I enter these notes to show that I know I'm in the F there. So the first lick would be like this. The second lick would sound like this. The only thing is that it ends a different way. So, of course, we're back in the C. Now we go down to the two Fs in the second line of the blues. Instead of playing it up here, I play it down here, because I want to play everything in this area of the fretboard. Starting on the 10th fret with the 3rd finger up to the 2nd, and you make this chromatic hammer on down in the C arpeggio. Try to play that really slow. We're down in the 2nd line again. 10th fret. 9th fret. And then we go back to the C. Just play that like this. So now we have played the first and the second line. Let me try to play from the start again and try to play really slow. In the I start up here in a 10th fret, 13th and 11th up in the first string. That's where what you play over the two chord, which is a C9, C minor 7 or a C minor 9. I hope you can see what I do. Chromatic up, hammer on. 13th fret, 10th fret, 12th fret, and 13th fret. Then the second lick starts the same way. So the last one would. Try to take that slow. So the two last would sound like this. Try to play all three lines quite slow. I'll try to play quite slow. Slower. Okay, it goes like this. Take a close look at these chords, and until the 8th bar it's actually just like a straight blues in C. So I start with a C9 with a very big voicing here. We could make it a bit smaller. We take this note here in the 7th fret, 5th string, 3rd fret, the 7th fret, the 3rd string down here, and we move up to the 8th fret, take this on the 4th string, and the last one down on the 2nd string. So we get this sound, and then you put the 4th finger down on the 2 top strings here. You get this sound. And then you are actually, if you can, you should add your thumb up here. So you get this large sound. Sometimes it sounds great to play such a large chord. One should not overdo it though. Okay, the next chord are you probably familiar with, F9. Moving down to the C again. F9. C. And now we are in the 8th bar, we move up to the 6th chord. The reason why it's called the 6th chord is that it's 6 note in the C scale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. this Jimi Hendrix chord, second finger in the fifth string, the 12th fret, first finger on the fourth string, 11th fret, and on the 12th fret, the third string, third finger, fourth finger up in the 13th fret, the second string. Okay, from that there we move to a, it's actually just a, you can see it's a D minor 7, which is obviously a 2 chord in the key of C, because it's C, D. D is the second note in the D, because of that it's called the second. And instead of playing the plain 7, minor 7, I add this 9 chord up here, this ninth note or interval up here, 12th fret, and then we move to this 9 that you know, G9, but again I add this note up here, so it gets a G13, and we end down in the C, and in the turnaround I play these. Down to an A7 sharp 5, down to a D9, down to a D7 sharp 5, so it, instead of playing it like this, I just go down to a 3 note chord, A7 sharp 5, D9, G7 sharp 5, and you're back in the... Thank you.